Hi everyone and welcome back. It's Vicky here and the lovely people at Ranger sent me a box full of new products, so I thought it would be fun if we open it up together so you can see what I got, and then another video will follow where I will be creating an art journal page using most of these products. So let's start with the first product that was in there. These are collage papers by Dina Weekly, and I'm going to open it up for you so you can see. These are actually tissue papers that are printed already, so they have black and white designs, and you can see that. I'm going to browse through all of them so you can see all the designs. Look how thin they are. This is actually tissue paper, and when you stick it on top of your canvas or your mixed media pages, then they look as if they are transparent. Now there are some scribbles, hearts. I think these are two. I'm just trying to separate them. Yes, they are two. So the scribbles, tons of tiny little hearts, lots of random dots, even more circles, some stripes, lovely big hearts, butterflies, and it even comes with a bunch of clear papers that you can use. These are great for using with your gel plate. Now there are actually 10 different pages here. And these are great when you don't know how to start on a page. Just pick one of those tissue papers with the designs and stick them down. They are a great start. Now I'm going to put those aside and let's see what else they sent me. And here are two products from their Delusions collection. So I got a set of their Delusions paint pens and this booklet, which is full of designs. And as I browse through them, you can see the designs included. And there are also lovely quotes to use on your art journal layouts. Now in this booklet, you get, let me see, 12 different designs, two of each. So 24 in total. You can cut them out, color them, and stick them on your art journal pages. Now this is a set of the Delusions paint pens, and it comes in three different sets actually, with six pens in each of the sets. And there is another one that has only black and white. Now these pens actually contain acrylic paint inside, the Delusions paint, which means that they will write opaque and they will write on top of pretty much anything. Just make sure that everything you want to write on top of it is quite dry, otherwise you might ruin your pens. Now when you get them, you will find that the paint is only at the back of the barrel and it doesn't go all the way to the tip. So the first thing you want to do with these markers is to help the paint to go all the way to the top, to prepare them. This is something that you have to do only once, and you have to do it for all of your markers so they are ready to go whenever you need them. Just put the cap back, as I did, and shake it very well. And now I'm going to press the nib on top of a piece of paper. And as you press that, you will be able to see the paint flow all the way from the barrel to that tip. Now don't do that up and down motion all the time. I know that there are people who do that, but this might overflow your nib and you don't want to do that. Just be patient, press the nib, and you will see that the paint will eventually go all the way to the tip. Now this is in real time, so you can actually see how long it takes for all that paint to go all the way to the bottom. Now just remember that this is something that you will do only once, and then your markers will be ready to go. The colors included in this pack are Bubblegum Pink, Tangerine Dream, Fresh Lime, Polished Jade, Slate Grey, and After Midnight. You can see that my pen is ready to go. I can draw my lines. You can see how fine those lines are. And just remember that just because this is a very fine tip pen, you need to make sure that as you write, you keep your pen straight, just like I'm doing here. I will show you the example and what I mean. If you try to write down something like that, as you would hold a normal pen, it doesn't write. Make sure that you keep it straight and it's going to write perfectly for you. Remember that this is acrylic paint in this barrel, so always put the cap back on, make sure that you hear the click sound, and they will last you for a long time if you take a good care of them. Never write on top of wet medium, just make sure that your page is dry before you go ahead and write with those pens. Now they also sent me a bottle of Glossy Accents, which I absolutely adore. I use it as a glue. It's a nice strong glue, but also as a medium for adding shine on my projects. Now they also sent me some products from their new Letter It collection. And this includes embossing powders. These are the metallics. And the colors are rose gold, gunmetal, navy and marigold. And these are the Tinsel's embossing powders, and the colors are gold, silver, bridal and copper, and they are really shiny. And these are their medium pens from their Letter It collection. Now these look the same, but they are not. There is actually different nibs on each of those packages. I'm going to open up one for you so you can see the nibs, but make sure to check out the packaging before you buy them. There are actually a brush tip, a bullet tip, there is a broad tip and a fine tip. And I'm going to open it up for you so you can see. This is the broad tip and this is the fine tip. And these are actually embossing markers that you can write down. You don't have to be a calligrapher to do it. You can write down anything you like and then apply embossing powder on top. Now, again, you don't have to be a calligrapher. You can use those on your art journals to do some scribbling or to do some marking like X's and O's and things like that and dots, and then apply your embossing powder on top. These are great and I will be using them a lot. Now let's put those aside and check what else they sent me. And I can see 3 sets of archival inks, and these really make me happy. I happen to have some of these colors, but not all of them, and I know I will be using these a lot, and especially the first set with all those sepia browns and black colors. Now I'm going to open it up so you can see how it is inside. But I didn't have any of those archival inks in this size. I do have the little cubes as well as the big ones, but not the small ones, and definitely not all these colors that they sent me. So I'm really happy for that. Thank you, Ranger. Now I'm going to bring in the other ones that I already have so you can see the difference in sizes. And I'm going to bring in one of the cubes that has been released a while ago so you can see the difference. I think that the new size is great. It's not as tiny as the little cubes and not as huge as the big archival inks. Plus, they are cheaper than the big archival ink pads. So the big archival ink pads used to be around $6, and now with $10 you get a set with 4 different colors, which I think is a great deal. And there is this box as well, which I haven't opened yet, and I want to see what's included. It's full of bottles, and these are the new shimmer sprays by Dilutions, all the colors. Super happy about those. Let me take them out for you so you can see. I was introduced to these while I was at Creativation. I saw Diane doing a demo using them. I know that they give a beautiful shine, I've seen it in your projects, but make sure to shake them before you start using them. You can see that the color inside the bottle is different than the bottom, and that's just because all the mica falls down and stacks at the bottom. That's why there is a little ball in there. It is going to help you as you shake it to mix up the mica with the rest of the color. And then it is ready to go. You can see how nicely mixed up everything is now. There are 12 colors and they all coordinate with the paints and the rest of the sprays by Dilutions. Now these bottles are smaller than the original sprays, the ones without the shimmer, which makes them cheaper, and that means that they made it easy for you to grab more colors that you love and use on your projects, so you can easily complete the collection. And let's take a look on the last products that they've sent me. So these are liquid pearls. They have a big collection of colors. These have all a beautiful pearlescent shine. And look how gorgeous these colors are. These are perfect for creating little dots and lines and embellish your cards as well as your mixed media projects. And they do have a very fine tip. I'm going to open up one bottle for you so you can see, which means that you can control easily the amount of the medium that you use. So these were all the products that I got from Ranger. Hope I helped you to decide if these products are for you. You will find links to all those products down below in the description area as well as on my blog. Now you can check out this video that I just posted where I am putting most of the new dilution sprays and products into use, creating a new art journal page. Thank you all for watching and I'll see you next time.